Welcome, and thank you for joining the Industry Insider webinar, AI and the Future of the Staffing Industry. I'm Amanda Javro, SVP, Chief Credit Officer at Tricom. As an administrative and financial solutions provider to the staffing and consulting industry, it is our philosophy to be an active member of the staffing industry by staying abreast of the ever-changing marketplace. For that reason, Tricom was pleased to launch the Industry Insider webinar series designed to share our expert knowledge and resources with our fellow staffing industry colleagues. One of our core values is to build relationships and become a leading resource to staffing and consulting firms nationwide. Our presenters today are Brad Smith, Chief Strategy Officer, Haley Marketing, and Jeff Gibson, CEO of Haley Marketing's sister company, Recruiters Websites. Today we are listening in on this conversation as Brad and Jeff explore the impact of AI in the staffing industry and how it can be leveraged as both a threat and an opportunity. They discuss the importance of embracing AI to future-proof jobs and businesses in the industry and provide examples of AI tools that can be used in business development, recruiting, and marketing. The conversation emphasizes the need for recruiters to combine AI automation with human outreach to enhance their effectiveness. Live examples of AI tools are demonstrated to showcase their potential in streamlining processes and improving efficiency. The conversation covers various topics related to candidate marketing, resume tailoring, finding more candidates, and to use the use of Talent Scribe for content creation. This Industry Insider session is broken out into three episodes and explore each of these themes in detail, providing insights and examples on how to leverage AI tools for recruitment and marketing purposes. So let's listen in.
Good afternoon, everyone. Thanks so much for joining. Today, we're going to be talking about AI, artificial intelligence, and how it's impacting the staffing industry. I'm going to wait till we jump into the presentation because we still have a lot of people coming into the Zoom meeting right now. So we'll wait another minute or two. But while we're waiting, I want to ask a favor. I want everybody that's on the call so far to use the chat feature in the bottom of your screen. Let us know about your experience or depth of knowledge using AI right now. Is this something that you're completely brand new to? You really haven't even tested. Is it something that you've tested a little bit, but you don't really know how you're going to implement this in your organization? Would you say that you've been using it for a little while and are comfortable with it, but want to see what else is out there? Or would you say that you are an AI expert and you should be with Jeff and I here talking about how this is impacting the staffing industry? So let us know where you are in terms of your AI depth, expertise, and knowledge. And this will help us a little bit with crafting what we discuss today. All right. So we've got Joseph who says lots of chat GPT and Dolly. Awesome. Pam is brand new. We've got Mark who's got minimal experience, really brand new. Let's see. Aiden has used ChatGPT for a while. That's about it. Aiden, I think a lot of people are in your similar situation. Terry has tested some, not sure how we're going to use it. I think a lot of companies are still in that spot where they're not sure where we're going to use it. Caitlin is using it and comfortable, but wants to know more. Michael, using it for job descriptions and some presentations to clients. Awesome. Awesome. Great. So it looks like we have a mix. We have a lot of people who have been using AI to some extent. The majority of people have mentioned ChatGPT specifically. We will dig into that and talk about that. But as we're going through today's presentation, what I really want to do is make this interactive. So if you're one of those people who are an expert in using ChatGPT or using AI for specific use cases, please add that to our chat so that we can share some of that expertise with everyone and we can learn as a group. If you're someone that is brand new, don't worry. We're going to talk about a lot of different tools here today. And what I want to reiterate to everyone is that you don't have to jump in and use everything. You don't have to jump in and try every single thing that we're mentioning today, because I think that would be overwhelming. Where I really suggest you start is to dip your toe in the water. Think about and look at the one or two nuggets that we shared today that really would be beneficial in your organization. And then we can go ahead and test, implement, see what happens. All right, so let's jump in here. And again, we're going to talk about AI in the future of the staffing industry. Is it an existential threat to everything that we do? Or is it a huge opportunity for us? And joining me today is Jeff Gibson. Jeff is the CEO of our sister company, Recruiters Websites. Jeff, thank you so much for joining us. I appreciate it.
Great to be here, Brad.
And myself, I'm Brad Smith. I'm the Chief Strategy Officer here at Haley Marketing Group. And about a year ago, we sat down and we said, all right, AI is going to change what we do. AI is going to change what we do here internally at Haley Marketing, at Recruiters Websites, and it is going to also change what's happening in the industry that we serve. So we wanted to get ahead of this. So we formed an AI task force and looked at key individuals in every single area of our organization, because AI can impact every single area of our organization. And we put together some plans, some processes. We've tested a variety of different AI platforms, AI tools. We're looking at integrating AI in all of our software as a service products and our processes and everything that we deliver and serve to our clients. So we're going to share some of what we've discovered. We're going to share what we're hearing in the staffing and recruiting industry. We're going to share what we've heard from other experts in the industry and outside of the industry so that we can collectively improve service delivery, be more efficient, and drive more results for our organizations. So let's jump in. And the way that we'll structure this is we'll talk about AI at a fairly high introductory level. Then we'll get a little bit more specific into recruiting, sales, and marketing things that you can do with AI right now. And then we'll wrap up by digging into some real world examples. So Jeff and I will pop out into ChatGPT, we'll pop out into a few other tools and introduce you to some things that you could be doing right now to drive efficiency and productivity in your organizations. All right. So to start off, AI has completely exploded. ChatGPT was released just about a year ago now, November 30th, 2022. And boy, how it has impacted things. When we look at tools that are available to us right now, we can use AI to assist with writing, with our design efforts, with payment processing, with web development, with our presentations and how we approach clients, with productivity and how we streamline and eliminate monotonous tasks. With automation, I know a lot of people in the chat had mentioned that they were using Sense or Bullhorn automation. There's great opportunity for us to streamline a lot of what we do, provide better service, and help in our day-to-day jobs. There's a bunch of images, imaging tools, writing tools, video tools, audio, coding, productivity. No longer do you need to know how to be a programmer to develop some amazing things. AI has streamlined so much of that. And if you do any search for very specific tools, you'll come up with almost what seems like a never-ending list of opportunities for us. It can help with research. A lot of people are already using it for writing. There are a ton of amazing marketing tools out there that help increase and improve the level of our branding efforts. There's sales AI tools that we'll get into. I know that's a big challenge for many staffing organizations right now. How do we sell new services? How do we drive more leads? We'll talk about some sales opportunities there. And then design, music, content creation. There's so many tools out there. For those that are new or those that are looking to explore what other opportunities are out there, I'd encourage you to go to a site called There's an AI for That. I love this database. It's amazing. And you can type in any specific thing that you're looking to accomplish or a topic or a theme. And it's going to report back a whole list of different AI tools, technology, software as a service that can help you solve and overcome and improve in those areas. So a simple search for recruiting, or interviewing or sourcing or lead generation. It's going to report back a whole list of different AIs and get you into the brainstorming mindset of what you could potentially do in your business to transform processes, to transform your organization using AI. So a great, great research tool. Now, I mentioned earlier that since ChatGPT came out about a year ago, there's been a ton of advancement. And even when we look back at the midpoint of this year, back in May 2023, there are about 3,700 AI tools out there. Fast forward to today, there's almost 9,500. Jeff and I were fortunate enough to do this similar presentation for another organization about a month ago. Since that time, there's been more than 1,500 new AI tools introduced in just a few weeks. It's absolutely amazing what you can do and what you can accomplish. And we're going to see this rapid growth in technology continue to move forward and continue to progress. What I want to caution you, and I mentioned this at the beginning, is that you don't have to use all of these tools. In fact, you'd be silly to. Instead, I want you to look at what things are monotonous, what things are holding your organization back, what things you could automate, and look for AIs to help do that. And we'll talk about a good place to start in a few slides here. But overall, we feel pretty strongly that AI will dominate every area of recruiting. And it's not going to stop at recruiting. It's going to be every area of business in general. AI will impact everything that we do on a daily basis. And it might even be more impactful than the advent of the internet itself. It's amazing the amount of tools that are available and how it can change and streamline what we do. So the question I get all the time, and it's starting to wean a little bit, but question I get is, are we facing an existential threat? Okay, if AI is truly going to change every area of recruiting, is it going to completely replace me as a recruiter? Is it going to eliminate the need for my job? And, you know, I liken this to a transformation we went through a decade or more ago. Monster came out and we thought to ourselves, oh my goodness, now companies can post their jobs online, accept applications, do everything that we provided and streamline the process and do it more cost effectively and efficiently. Then Indeed came out and said, we are going to own search for jobs so that when anybody is searching for a position, we are going to be in the forefront and we're going to be search optimized and we're going to own rankings and own that traffic. We thought to ourselves, oh my gosh, what are we going to do? LinkedIn came out and you have this database of professionals. How easy is it going to be to replace a recruiter now? Because all of these candidates across the entire economy, across the entire US, are freely available out there on LinkedIn. Any HR professional, any internal recruiter can use LinkedIn to recruit. We're afraid these were all going to put us out of business. Now, I'm fortunate enough to have Jeff here. And before Jeff launched and started Recruiters Websites, he was in the recruiter seat himself. He was working in the family business and had gone through this wave, this influx of new technology. Jeff, if you can remember and think back to when all of these started to come out, did you think they were going to put you out of business?
So I didn't, but my dad did. In fact, a little story. We weren't allowed to use LinkedIn and we weren't allowed to use mass mail, believe it or not. But my dad took my mom on a trip to Hawaii for a couple of weeks. That was like their 25th anniversary. And it was me and my sister. We had about a year experience apiece. And he came back and we made 14 placements. And we're in the executive recruiter space. We work in the insurance industry. And he wanted to know what we did. So I said, Dad, we worked on LinkedIn and we sent out mass mail. And he's like, and that worked? And I was like, yeah, it worked. So if we're going to just get stuck behind the times, you're going to make a little bit of money still. You're still going to make placements. But we got to keep up with what everyone else is doing. And if there's a faster, easier, better way to do it, let's do it.
I love that story. I love how you just waited until he went on vacation and you're like, hey, surprise, Dad.
Yeah. Yeah. That was my strategy from then on. I had to get him out of the office to try something new.
There you go. So send him on vacation, try something new. I love it. I'm sure he kind of appreciated that as well.
Yeah, I hope he's not watching.
Yeah, you might be in trouble if he is. So I love that story because I hear from a lot of staffing companies right now. Hey, we've put a hold on anything AI. We are afraid of the risk associated with it. We are afraid of implementing this in our company. We're afraid of allowing our team to use it. And in some cases that's founded, we need to make sure that we set things up properly. We have the right process. We have the right safeguards in place. But to Jeff's point, if he wasn't using mass mailing, if he wasn't using the tools that were available at the time, they probably would have made that number of placements. And I say the same thing about AI. I don't think that AI is going to replace the recruiter, but I will say this. I think AI will replace the recruiter that doesn't use it. Because the ones that do are going to be so much more effective, so much more efficient. The staffing salespeople that use AI are going to be able to reach a much wider audience and have a bigger opportunity to close sales, get that job order, and the recruiters will be more likely to fill those open job recs by using AI. And I want to share a story that I just recently heard at Staffing World, and I think is a great microcosm of how AI can really help. So they did a study where they took high-level chess players and they pitted them against the AI. And they said, all right, you're gonna face the AI head-on. Okay, these, again, are championship, high-level, best-in-the-world chess players. They lost to the AI 100% of the time. They didn't win a match. But then they said, all right, we're going to take these same chess players and we're going to let them use the AI to help them in the decision-making process. So the AI wasn't making the decision itself, and the human chess player wasn't making the decision themselves. They were working back and forth, using AI to make educated decisions. And what they found was that the human using AI beat the AI alone the majority of the time. Okay, so there's a huge opportunity for us to make better decisions, to be faster, to be more strategic if we use and leverage AI. But it's not going to replace us because the human combined with the AI is going to outperform the AI. So let's think about ways that we can use it more effectively. Let's not be scared that AI is going to be the death of the recruiter, that it's going to replace that recruiter. Let's think about ways that we can use it to add more value to the equation and engage with people more quickly and more effectively. And the reality is, there's so much challenge right now in the market. We've got 3.9% unemployment, just ticked up a little bit, but there's still over 3 million more jobs than candidates, and that's just in the U.S. market. We're seeing record number of retirements. The baby boomers are leaving the workforce. We've had a population deficit. Our birth rate has been lower since the 70s. Okay? It's impacting the workforce today. We've seen a rise in the gig economy, in freelance work, in people going down the entrepreneurial path and launching their own businesses. All of this is reducing the talent pool for higher level positions. It's a challenge right now. And these talent shortages are systematic. There's no end in sight, right? The population numbers are immigration laws and rules. Everything is impacting this. Even something like the opioid epidemic is impacting the available talent pool. Okay, so it's a little bit scary for the U.S. workforce, but it's great for the staffing and recruiting industry. Your resources are going, and your tools and your process and the service you deliver is going to be in high demand. Okay, but the companies that do it most effectively, most cost effectively, most efficiently are going to be the ones to rise to the top. So when you're thinking about this and how you approach the market, I think there's a few ways to approach this. As a staffing and recruiting agency, what bucket are you going to fall into? You could be a scout. Okay. With the shortage of talent, there's going to be a need for people to go out there and actively scout talent. Look for the up-and-comers. Look for the people who have potential that could go into that next role, that next level. Look for untapped talent pools. Maybe there are people with some difficulties learning. Maybe it's somebody that is on the autism spectrum. Maybe it's a second chance. Maybe it's a area of the population that is underserved. Maybe it's helping organizations recruit bilingual managers and then build a non-English speaking workforce. There's so much opportunity out there, but that's what a talent scout could do. You could take the other route and you could take the Jerry Maguire approach and be a talent agent. When demand is greater than the supply, you've got to be a scout to find the talent. But if you think about professional sports, agents exist to help people get the best possible deal, to take and pitch their skills, their background, their experience to organizations. So you could reposition yourself as a talent agent to help a limited pool of professionals find the best opportunity to optimize what they're making and what their potential is. Whatever path you take, though, I think that we do need to be aware and cognizant that we have to be experts in AI if we're going to gain market share. So AI will, I believe, help you future-proof your own jobs and your business. At a recent conference, this is not Staffing World, but one conference before, we were at a roundtable where we were talking about AI and what impact it will have. And it was interesting to me, the divergence of thought in where AI was going to take it. You had some people who are like, this is going to completely replace the recruiter. I'm firing everybody in my company and I'm going to run the show myself with AI, which I think is unrealistic. And then on the other end, you had recruiters who said, there is no way AI will replace what I do. I'm irreplaceable and forget it. I'm not using it because it's all about people. I think we're somewhere in the middle. I think reality is somewhere in the middle. We went back and forth with the person who said that AI won't have any impact on what they do. And where we ended up was that he felt strongly that recruiting, that staffing is all about building a connection with the candidate on a personal level. And I didn't disagree. I think that's so right. I think that's where you add so much value in the relationship, is building that personal connection, truly understanding that candidate. And then I followed up and I asked him, you know, out of all the applications that you get, how often are you able to have those discussions? How often are you able to get down to that level of conversation, of connection? And it was a minor percentage of people that walked through the door that he was able to do that with. So I looked at him and I said, what if AI could help you connect with more people on a personal level? What if we could get people through the onboarding and the application process so quickly that you were able to have a bigger percentage of people that you could build those relationships with, because AI eliminated a lot of the administrative? And all of a sudden, the light bulb went off in his head. You could see it. And I think he finally realized, hey, there is a place for AI in what I do every day. And if it can help me streamline the administrative tasks that are burdening me, even something as simple as data entry or resume parsing, then I could spend more of my time on those thoughtful relationships. And that's where he really makes his money. So think about it in those terms. It doesn't have to completely revolutionize everything that you do, but it should impact and make you more effective, more efficient, more productive. So let's get into it. AI in recruiting. There are a bunch of tools out there. Here are just a few. If you Google the best AI sourcing tools, a bunch will come up. But here are some that we've looked at, that we've tested, and we'll get into some more specifics. But something like a Paradox, really expensive chatbot, but it provides an amazing candidate experience. You've got Converse AI, where it allows you to do high volume outbound calls, outbound candidate reach, and not just text messaging, but actually voice calls, text, SMS, email, everything. It's a virtual recruiter and it'll conduct interviews and candidate screening on your behalf so that you can get to that more personal relationship faster, quicker. It's a tool like DeepBrain that does AI interviewing and pre-screening. Let's eliminate all of those people that are just hitting bulk apply. There is a tool like BeHuman, which will personalize video at scale. A candidate that does video interviewing and AI. There's Enrich Data. I love this one. It will go through and help you do a GitHub search and do a candidate analysis so that you can find people for high-tech positions that aren't out there actively looking for a job but are open to gig assignments or something else. Jeff is going to demo a tool he's developed called Talent Scribe, which will completely revolutionize the content writing side for staffing and recruiting companies. And we'll get a quick demo of that at the end of today's presentation. But there's so many opportunities out there for us to improve what we're doing at every step of the recruiting process. So here are some of the things that AI is going to help us do. It's going to help us identify the best times to be hiring for whatever position that you're looking for. And it's going to vary by position, by industry, by platform. It's going to help us streamline and let us know the best times to be doing these activities. We'll predict profitability of finding or probability of finding and cost of a talent. And Matt Lozar from our team right now uses technology to help make better decisions on where to invest recruitment advertising budgets using programmatic tools. It's a great opportunity to streamline costs, save your organization money, and fill more positions. We can identify people and processes that result in the best hires. You can compare recruiters for different types of positions. You might find one recruiter excels with a certain subset of people or a certain subset of jobs. Okay, you can use your internal people more effectively. You can look at forecasting a new hire or a potential hire's career trajectory and what skills or backgrounds or past experience make for a great employee moving forward. Accelerating time to hire, which is so important. Eliminating poor fit candidates. We're starting right now to see AI job applications take hold. Okay, you may see a mass increase in applications from unqualified candidates because they're using AI to complete job applications. Well, let's use AI to weed out those poor fit candidates and screen them. Okay, big opportunity for us there. Overall, we want to look for ways to make your job easier or at least make you more productive.
Thanks for listening in to this episode of the TRICOM Industry Insider webinar on AI and the future of the staffing industry. We'll see you in our next episode.